Gotta make sure you guys are real people. Perfect. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, well, do you guys ever wish you could bring the serenity of nature into your own home? Well, people like you and people like me really love to have houseplants in their house, but sometimes, like, you know, you just can't take care of them and they die, and that's bad. Well, today I have a three-step process of how I set up my own container garden. And before I dive in, though, let's talk kind of about the soil materials or what a soil is. In 2003, Oregon State said that the ideal soil had provided physical support, water, air, and nutrients to the plant and the soil organism inside of it. And so the first material that we're going to use that has some support for the plant, for the soil organisms, is coconut core. Coconut core is a light, airy material, kind of like it's the husk of coconut. And it holds the water like a sponge, and it's very airy, and the plants the roots can move easily through them and multiply and spread out, and get to know the material. One con though is that it's salty, and you do need to wash it out with plenty of water before you start planting. Our next material we're going to talk about is perlite. A common misconception with perlite is that it's out of plastic. It's actually a volcanic ash. It's from Montana. And some pros associated with it, it's a glass, it holds very little water, and so the water drainage capacity is great, and water just flows right through it. And because of that, it also has great aeration qualities. And the plants, like I said, from Oregon's study, they really need that air, and this is great for supplying. A con, though, is that companies like this one, Miracle-Gro, they put in synthetic fertilizers, slow release ones usually, and these can burn your seedlings, which is bad. Kill them. As many as you get them. And on to my next one, my favorite component is my compost. I love this because it varies so much with so many different resources. And this one, today I decided to use some mushroom compost. Compost is great because it has great water retention qualities. It holds it like better than anything else out there. And it provides great nutrients that will never burn your plant. The only bad thing though is, as you can see kind of with it on my hand, is it's muddy. And it'll get real muddy real quick if you don't balance it out. It's actually a great thing to do at home. It helps reduce your carbon footprint on the environment. And an author in a 2009 January article from the magazine Mother Earth News reported she saved $60 the first year on new soil supplies. The first year she started composting. And the second year she hoped to be completely self-sufficient, which is pretty cool and quite commendable. Anyways, now that I have talked a little bit about the materials, let's talk about the nutrients inside of them. Inside of the compost, there was organic nutrients. And the organic nutrients I love because they can never really burn the plant. The plant easily absorbs it. The cons, though, it could also be a pro, is it's slow acting. And, it'll feed the plant over time, which I like it. It's a pro for me. But some people want that feeding right away, which you're going to get more with synthetic, which segues into synthetic. Synthetics have been a modern tenet of agriculture, meaning that modern agriculture relies heavy on this. They're fast and they're effective, but they also, if used improperly, could potentially kill your plants, and they're also very detrimental to the environment. And lastly, but not least, they're expensive. Because I didn't mention, compost is completely free if you make it by yourself, as I mentioned with the article. I brought here today a fully planted mixture of all these materials. Since I have three, I mixed them in components of thirds, and this is what you're going to kind of look like. I mean, I don't really know how to show you guys, but this is some basil. The roots, I love basil. This actually is from Greece, believe it or not. My neighbor went to Greece and brought back some. The cuttings, the roots came out really well because I followed a procedure outlined by University of Missouri procedure in 2012. It came out really well, and these are going to be really hardy. But on to some maintenance. University of Illinois website launched this year recommends the finger method, which is sticking your finger knuckle deep and then seeing if it's moist. Right now it's dry, so that means this could be some water. My favorite method, though, is to pick up the container to gauge the weight and to see if it's heavy. If it's heavy, that means it's water. If it's not heavy, it needs some water. Eventually, I should mention that you're going to need to repot this. The roots are going to need some more soil, more nutrition. And And so, yeah, that pretty much wraps up my presentation. Today we focused on the materials that you were going to use. There's a plethora. I just chose some that are easily available and cheap. We focused on nutrients, you know, there's organic, synthetic, and then we also focused a little bit on some maintenance. Thank you guys so much for coming and giving me your undivided attention. Have a great day.
Thank you.